They take off and they run fast. And before long, they run out without instructions, run out without foundation. And the enemy beats them up. For some, lose their very lives. Turn back totally on God. Never want to run anymore. I'm telling you tonight, God wants you to stay in the race. There's all kinds of things that may have fallen in your life. But you know what? You got to close some pages in your life and start anew. Don't live on what happened 2 or 3 years ago. I'm a brand new man today. If folks see me in the road, if they were to say, "Red man, you used to," I said, "You said it right. I used to. Not doing that anymore." Now let me tell you the new story. So you don't want to be ashamed of where you've been if you can bring your testimony to where you are now. But brothers and sisters, there must be a change. God told me to bring this message to you tonight because the enemy is trying to wear you out, trying to make you prove a point that you are holy and you love God. God told me to tell you, just be holy. Just be holy. There are saints that have gone on before us. They ran the race. They didn't all do it perfectly. But the mystery was they didn't quit. They got back up and they continued unto the end. That's what the Apostle Paul said. I fought a good fight. It didn't mean he won every fight. But he was there for the next one. I may have lost the first one, but I'm catching on to your tactics. I win the second. I may lose the third. I win the fourth. Then I'm catching on. I win the fifth. I win the sixth. You understand? And then it gets to where you're winning because you're learning the voice of God. You're growing steps. You keep yourself encouraged that the race is not given to the swift, neither the battle to the strong, but to the one that endured to the end. And I really want you to see that, because if you're running to try to catch up with somebody else, you don't know what it took for them to get where they are. Don't run on up there because you don't have any idea what they're having to go through. And people look at me now, "Bishop, man, I don't want to be a bishop one of these days." I'm saying, boy, they have no idea. It's like Paul and Paul trying to tell them, "I'm a prisoner. I am. I'm bought and paid for. But I don't belong to Prophet James, I belong to one of Williams. But I don't belong to her, I belong to Rockhead or Joseph." And all the time in the middle of all that, I belong to you. Because I've given myself to God. Isn't that something? And God trusts me with you. Because he knows if he feeds me, if I have a love for him, I'm going to feed you. I'm telling you tonight, you can stay in the race. And your joy can be fulfilled. Whatever you desire in your life, it's not too late. I'm telling you, but here's the secret. Don't tell everybody your dreams. Don't share your desired dreams with everybody. Child, there's a single man over there. He really looked at it. Oh, child, don't worry about him. Don't nobody want him. Better watch that. I don't mess with him. I heard he ain't no good. Yo, yeah. And he the first one trying to keep everybody away from him. Y'all know that story? So if you think it's something you want, you're just kind of going to be like the cat. And just take your time and make your steps. You know? Cat don't make no loss in the after rat. He just takes his time. Keep your eyes on him. Gets close, close. You got to have a strategy. You got to have a prayer life. But you can't be up today and down tomorrow. Up today down, Lamar. That's not a consistent race, and those that's following you can't be encouraged by you. Somebody may be looking at you and saying, my children, a good wife. Someone else may be saying, he'll make you a good husband. But if they see you up and down, not consistent, then they're scratching their head. And they got reasons to scratch their head, because if you're like that in your spiritual life, then you are missing the natural life. Are you hearing me? This is all about will. I thank God for my job that I got right now. I thank God for the place that I am. Thank God for the people I work with. Whether this is this women's conference, and I've been in women's conference anywhere. My bits have paper everywhere.